Microsoft Power Toys. If you haven't heard me talk about it before, it's an incredibly useful set of tools for Windows that is published by Microsoft. And since my last video about this, they've gone through several updates and added a bunch of new tools, so I figured I'd make an updated video with those new tools and features. If you want to install it, there's two main ways. One is right through the Microsoft Store, and also you can get it from Microsoft's GitHub page. They have the releases on there. The current version is 0.73. Just to be sure, if you install it from the Microsoft Store, that you have it checked for updates so you know that it has the latest version. So let's just get into the new tools, starting off with the System Tray Quick Launch menu. Now, if you click the icon in the System Tray, it pops up a menu with shortcuts for certain tools. This might not exactly be a tool in itself, but I think it still counts. And I will note that it's not going to show a shortcut for every single tool because for some of them it wouldn't make sense, but these are the ones that do show at the moment if all tools are enabled. And you can also click the More button to look through all the possible tools and enable them or disable them from there. Next up, we have Mouse Without Borders, which is pretty cool. It basically lets you use your cursor for your mouse across multiple devices seamlessly. I believe all the computers have to be on the same network, but you basically generate a key on the one computer and put in the other, which allows it to connect. You can even choose to have it share the clipboard across the different devices and even use the clipboard to share and move files under a certain size. I believe at the moment it's 100 megabytes. There's also lots of other settings you can look through having to do with security or how the mouse cursor behaves, but you can just look through those. Moving on, we have Paste as Plain Text, which is pretty self-explanatory. Basically, if you have any text in the clipboard that has formatting, such as font size or color or underline, something like that, if you use the Paste as Plain Text shortcut, it will paste it without all that formatting, just the raw text, which usually means that the program itself will decide what the formatting will be, so it usually will match the content that you're pasting it into. The next new tool is called Peek, which in File Explorer with the shortcut, it lets you preview files pretty quickly. I actually could not get this one to work in my case. It opened up the window but didn't actually show anything, but you can see what it should look like. And also, if a preview window is open, you can use the arrow keys to navigate through other files to preview. All right, next up, we have the new tool Registry Preview, which lets you open .reg registry files and see what's in them, but in a way that is a lot easier than the normal way, which is to open it with Notepad or something, which can be very unreadable depending on how much is in there. With this new tool, you can see it does show you the text on the left, but also on the right-hand side, the key and value structure that you'd normally see with the registry editor. And you can also have it open the registry editor directly to the key if you want, so you don't have to search for it. And if you click on different keys in that window, it'll also update and show you what's in that below. Another neat thing that I noticed is if the reg file would delete a certain key, it'll actually show that with a trash can icon, so that's pretty neat. Now, the next tool is Crop and Lock, and this one's pretty cool. When you press the shortcut, it lets you select a region of the current program, and whatever you outline and select, it will create a second new window just with that selected region. And it actually updates it in real time if the original window changes, and also the cropped window will stay on top. This could definitely be useful, for example, if you need to reference another program, but you don't want to have that program's window all the way open and blocking something. There's also this reparent option with a separate shortcut where instead of creating a copy window that's cropped, it actually crops the original window. And then when you close the cropped version, it reopens the original. One quick thing to note, if you want to use this tool on a program that's running as administrator, you also have to have PowerToys running as administrator. And the next new tool is actually part of the mouse utilities set, and this is called Mouse Jump. When you go to use this with the shortcut, it will bring up a small image of all your monitors for your computer, and wherever you click, it moves your mouse to the place you clicked on your actual monitors. Probably useful if you have a bunch of screens, though I noticed that the default shortcut is kind of clunky, so you might want to remap that. So those are all the completely new tools, but a lot of the other existing tools also got some features added, so here's some of the notable ones that I noticed. First of all, the Keyboard Manager tool, which lets you remap keys, now supports the numpad, so you can remap those keys. Also, the Text Extractor tool, one of my personal favorites, now lets you change the default language to any other ones that you have installed. Just be sure to read the thing that talks about installing the proper optical character recognition packs to go along with any additional additional languages you install. Next, for the PowerToys run tool, this already has a ton of functionality, so I'm not gonna be able to cover it all, but a couple of things they added is now you can use it to open MSC files, which are like management consoles, such as the group policy editor. You couldn't before, apparently. They also added several new plugins, which lets you kind of select specific functionality that you want to enable or disable. One of them lets you list the currently running processes if you just wanna look through those. It's called Window Walker, and it's activated using the less than sign you type in. Another new one is the value generator, which is activated with the number sign. And this can actually do a bunch of stuff. For example, you can have it generate a random GUID, or you can also have it encode or decode base 64 text strings. So you can look at Microsoft's documentation page for PowerShell Run to see all the other stuff it can do, because there's quite a lot. And finally, for you IT managers out there, you should probably know that all releases of PowerToys now include a set of group policy objects you can install, which should make it easier to deploy a bunch of machines with PowerToys and only specific tools enabled if you want to do that. All right, so I believe I covered all the main new features, or at least the ones that I thought were interesting. Let me know down in the comments if I maybe missed any, or if there are some underrated features you think are really cool. And again, I only talked about new tools since my last video. I'll put links to my previous ones in the description if you want to see examples of all of them. So if you enjoyed this video, be sure to give it a very small thumbs up, not a big thumbs up, only a small one this time. And if you want to subscribe, I try to make videos about twice a week, usually Wednesday and Saturday. And if you want to keep watching, I'll put links to the previous two videos I made about PowerToys, so you can see all the tools right there. So thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.